So welcome back to the channel, I'm Vic, your host. I got a request from a viewer on my Benfica Tactics video who wrote, "Can you do a video on how to play with FC Porto?" Well, of course I can. So Porto is a 4-star team in PES 2021, and in this video I'll explain how to play with them using this formation, which players I would use in each position, and I'm also gonna show you some clips and highlights from matches I played, where I explain player runs and movement, show some goals and stuff like that. So let's dive right into it. So let's start with the formation, which is a 3-2-3-2. Kinda. It's a fluid formation, so this is how it looks offensively, and defensively it's more a little bit more compact. If we take a look at the instructions here, we have possession game, attacking style, and then short pass build up, attacking wide while maintaining formation and with low to medium support range. So basically what I want to accomplish offensively is having possession, obviously. Playing short passes, you have some players here who can play short. You don't have that many passing options for long range passing, so I want to keep it short, and there's a lot of technical quick players here, so short passing works really well. Also, I want to attack wide using my wingers. You have on the left side, I will get back to the players later, but I can mention that you have Nakajima on the left side who can use both feet. You can cut inside, you can go around and cross. And on the opposite side you also have Corona, who also has a pretty good weak foot. So you can go around and cross with his right foot, or you can cut inside and pass with his, or shoot with his left foot. So you have a lot of options. And you want to attack wide to try to overload the defending team's backs. Basically, to try to get easy tap-ins and headers and stuff like that. So this is a situation from a game against Udinese. Uribe has the ball here. I'm gonna switch it over to the left side and try to create something there. So let's play it through here and see what happens. Nakajima receives it here. Oliveira out to Diaz. Diaz with the 1-2 with Nakajima. Diaz goes inside and hits Taremi with the easy header. On defense, we are doing frontline pressure, trying to contain them into the center. Because we are playing three at the back, we need our wingers to come back often. Depends really who you're playing and what tactics your opponent is using, but either way, we want to try to keep them inside, where we have a lot of players, and we have aggressive pressuring. We have a pretty high defensive line and low compactness. It's more important to me with this team to have every player, every area on the pitch covered by at least one player, instead of parking the bus and swarming the box. I won't do that with this team. Instead, I want to try to keep every area covered with at least one player to snap up passes and interceptions and stuff like that to try to get the ball back. To take a quick look at the advanced instructions, I'm hugging the touchline. Both Corona and Nakajima will stay out wide and try to stretch the defense. And then I have defensive duties on Uribe. What I will do in some games where my opponent, for example, has a 4-3-3 with wingers, or if I see that he's planning on using his wide midfielders a lot offensively, I will activate the wingback instruction, so both Nakajima and Corona will pull back defensively. So up front we have Mehdi Taremi. It's a fox in the box, typical striker. He's tall, 187, right-footed. He can finish, he can head, he has some kicking power, he has decent ball control, not that good of a passer, and he has the heading skill, the ship shot skill, he has rising shot, acrobatic finishing. He has the one-touch pass, which is good to use when you try this combination triangle plays. So this is from the game against Tottenham. I'm down 2-1. Taremi has the ball here, and as you can see, a lot of players are pushing forward to get something going here. This is Corona, and then you have Otavio, you have Oliveira, this is Felipe Anderson, and you have Nakajima up here. So let's play and see what happens. Taremi plays it wide to Corona. Corona's gonna hit Taremi again. Out to Otavio, and then Taremi's gonna finish with the naughty ship. Behind Taremi, you have two attacking midfielders. Felipe Anderson will have the second striker role, while Marega will have the attacking midfielder role. And the reason for this I will get back to later when I go in depth on Corona. But with Felipe Anderson, you can do a lot of stuff. So this is a creative playmaker. You can play on the left side. He has good dribbling, decent passing, decent curl. He has good speed and decent kicking power. He has some dribble skills, but I don't use them too much. What I did use Felipe Anderson for was the long range drive. I tried to get those curling shots with his right foot. So in this clip we're gonna see a Felipe Anderson goal. It all starts by Taremi here winning the ball back. He's gonna do a 1-2 with Otavio, and Otavio's gonna find Felipe. So let's play it through here. You see Felipe positioning to get a shot off, and he curls it in the corner. So here is another goal by Felipe Anderson. Oliveira and Grujic are gonna strip Salah of the ball. They're gonna pass it to Corona, then Corona is gonna do a lofted through pass to Felipe. We see Oliveira short pass to Corona, and Corona does the lofted through pass with his left foot. And Corona and Felipe is through. He does the super cancel fake shot and places it in the corner for a great goal. And then with Marega, he's a dummy runner. He can play anywhere up front. He has finishing, he has heading, he has good speed, he has kicking power, he has heading, chip shot, long range shooting, first time shot. He's a super sub and he has fighting spirit. So in this situation, it's Luis Diaz cutting inside from the left side. He's gonna pass out to Corona, who is making a run out here. Inside of him, you have Otavio getting ready to make his run. And as center forward for this game, I have Marega. So let's take a look here at how it progresses. Corona receives the ball and is gonna do a one-touch pass here. You see Otavio is all open. And he attracts the attention of the central defender, leaving Marega wide open. And he scores the easy header. So this is a situation from a game against Barcelona. I'm down 2-0. He's just hit the bar and I'm picking up the rebound with Marcano, and I'm gonna try to launch a counter here. Oliveira with the ball. He finds Felipe Anderson. Felipe is gonna go with the ball, be patient, try to find the opening. He's gonna hit Taremi, and Taremi is gonna cross it to Marega for the counter. What I like about Marega in this role, he will do a lot of runs, being a dummy runner. So this is a situation from a game against Udinese. Corona just received the ball here and is passing it inside to Uribe. And we're gonna try to launch an attack here. Let's take a look. We have Marega here, Taremi here. Uribe receives the ball. It's gonna see Marega getting in behind. He's gonna be patient and find Taremi, who scores easily. With Corona on the right side, he's basically the playmaker on this team. At least that's what I used him for. If we take a quick look at him, he's an offensive fullback. He inspires low pass and lofted pass and dribble through. He can basically play anywhere on the field. He has ball control, he can pass, he has curl, he has decent speed. And he has the double touch, he has the cut behind and turn, he has one touch passing, he has through passing, he has pinpoint crossing, he has low lofted pass and interception. Okay, so in this clip I'm gonna show you what you could do with Corona when receiving the ball and there's no one in front of the goal. So instead of having to cross or stuff like that or passing it back, you could do some dribbles with him. So let's take a look here what I do. So this is from a game against Lyon. I'm down 2-0 in this one. I have Corona up here. Let's play through and take a look. Corona gets the ball. He goes inside, and he finishes off with this outside. So this is from a game against Marseille. I've just had the ball on the left side with Felipe Anderson, but I've decided I want to turn it around and try to get Corona open here. To Marcano. Marcano's gonna wait. He's gonna find Otavio. He hits Corona, who hits Taremi for the header. You give the ball to Corona. You can either dribble with him, you can pass with him, you could cut inside and shoot as well. And in the games where Marega couldn't play, you could put in Otavio from the bench. Otavio is a hole player, so he will make a lot of the same kind of runs that Marega will do. But I prefer Marega because of his speed. So Otavio has ball control, he has passing, he has curl, he has decent speed and kicking power. He has through passing, which is really neat. And he also has the super sub. So this is from a game against Udinese. You have Corona on the ball, on the right wing. You have Otavio making a run here. In the box, you will have Taremi. So let's play through here and see what happens. Corona has the ball. He's gonna go with the ball. Make some dribbles. And he hits Otavio with the through ball. It's gonna cut a little bit and find Taremi for the tap-in. Another option as attacking midfielder or second striker is Romario Baro. This is also a hole player, so he will make a lot of runs. He has the ball control, he has the curl, he has some speed and some kicking power. He's not that good of a passer or a finisher, but he's a decent guy to put on from the bench because of his playing style. He will make the runs, and if it's late in the game and you get some extra space on counters, he will be more than good enough. He does have some skills here. He can first time shoot, he can do the rising shot, he can through pass, weighted pass and low lofted pass. Okay, so we have a situation here in a game against Udinese. Corona's gonna receive the ball on the right side. You see we have Romario Baro. Let's see what happens. Corona receives the ball. He's gonna find the run of Romario Baro. He's gonna cross it inside. And Taremi loopheads the keeper. On the left side, I started with Nakajima. This is a roaming flank type of player, so it's not ideal on the left wing when you have the hug the touchline instruction, but I chose to start with this guy because he has a lot of decent skills here. He can dribble, he can pass, he has curl, he has speed, he has kicking power, he has a lot of skills, he has the double touch, which I used a lot. He can long range drive, he can through pass, he has weighted pass, he has pinpoint crossing. And as I mentioned earlier, he's right footed, so you can go inside and do the long range drives with him with his right foot. Or you could go around and cross with his left foot because he has 4-star weak foot. So this is from a game against Tottenham. I'm down 2-0, but I'm about to make a good comeback here. It's gonna end 3-3. But in this situation, Sarr is on the ball, and I think we have Nakajima here, and this is Oliveira, and we have Uribe, and let's see how we build it up. Sarr's gonna pass to Nakajima, who's gonna pass to Oliveira, who lays it off to Taremi. Quick pass to Felipe. Felipe's gonna hit Nakajima, who does a beautiful double touch. He's gonna go inside and hit Taremi for the header. The other option on the left, as left midfielder, is Luis Diaz, a young Colombian. He's also right-footed, playing on the left side. This guy is a prolific winger, so he perhaps he'll suit that role better than Nakajima with this tactical setup. He has the dribbling, he has very good speed, he has some kicking power. He's not the best passer nor finisher, he can't head, but he does have a lot of skills. He also has the one-touch pass, he can pinpoint cross, and he has the super sub. So that's another reason why I kept him on the bench and started Nakajima. Basically, it really depends on the in-game form as well. If Diaz has better form arrow than Nakajima, I would start Diaz. Well, centrally in the midfield, you have a couple of box-to-box midfielders. I chose to go with Oliveira as the more offensive one, and then I stuck defensive duties on Uribe. So Oliveira inspires lofted pass with one star, he's right-footed, he has the ball control, he can pass, he has some curl, he's really slow, but he does have some kicking power. He has the double touch, long range drive, he has weighted pass and low lofted pass. And then we have a situation against Marseille. It's 2-2, it's late in the game. I've just won the ball back with Oliveira, who is here. He's passed the ball to Taremi, who's gonna pass it again. We also have Otavio making a run here, and we have Marega up here. So let's take a look what happens. Taremi hits Oliveira. Oliveira will go back to Taremi, to Otavio, to Taremi. Taremi's gonna cross it in, and Oliveira finishes what he started with his head. So here we have a free kick from about 20 meters out, and Oliveira is gonna hit it in the near corner. So this is a situation in a game against Udinese. Luis Diaz is going to receive the ball out to the left. And then you have Oliveira here supporting him. You have Romario Baro. And you have Taremi in here. So let's see what happens. So Oliveira gets the ball. He does a dribble. He finds Taremi for the tap-in. And then we have a free kick with Sergio Oliveira. It's the game against Tottenham. It's 2-2. So let's take a look what happens here. The goalie is gonna try to save it, but it goes in either way, it's too powerful. Great goal by Oliveira. And then you have Mateus Uribe, also a box-to-box, right-footed. This guy has decent passing, he has some speed and some kicking power, but he's mainly in there because of his defensive overall central midfield attributes. He does have the double touch, he can shoot a little bit from range, he has the first time shot. He has interception and fighting spirit, which I like for a player in this role. Another option centrally is Grujic, who is an anchor man. He inspires lofted pass with one star, he's really tall. Basically this guy is tall and is slow, but he can pass, which is his strength. He has some ball control, he also has some kicking power. He does have the double touch, he can head, he can shoot from range. He has one touch pass, low lofted pass. He also has man marking, interception and fighting spirit. So if you compare these two, the main reason I chose Uribe was basically his speed. I want someone, with Oliveira being pretty slow as well, I want someone in the midfield that is as quick as possible. Especially when he's playing defensive duties, he won't be to be able to chase down players and stuff like that with this guy. Although, I mean, Grujic, you can make the case for Grujic being the better option, at least offensively here. In my three-back line defensively, I have Sarr on the left side, Pepe in the middle, and Marcano on the right side. The reason I chose to go with three at the back is I felt that when they sold Alex Telles to Manchester United, they lost their left back obviously, but they don't have a good replacement here yet. And with Corona being as good as he is offensively, I didn't want to waste him as a right back. Because of that, I chose to go with three at the back instead of a four back line. And this way I can also use the central defenders in the squad, because you actually have, I would say, two good central defenders in Marcano and Pepe, and then you have three decent in Sarr and Mbemba and Leite. This uses the squad depth a little bit better than going with a 4-4-2 or a 4-3-3 or something like that. And in goal we have Marchesin, Argentine offensive goalie. He does have the low punt, which is useful for counters and getting the play started quickly. So thanks so much for watching this video. I will do an online division gameplay series with FC Porto in the near future, so consider sticking around and subscribing to the channel. Do you have any requests for other teams for me to review? Please leave a comment below. Thank you, and I will see you in the next one.